But yeah, $13.48 million, almost $13.5 million raised last year, which is awesome. So 107 different countries represented by gamers last year. Stop. We already saw people eat ice cream. Okay, relax. Oh, yeah, look at that. All right. Welcome, everyone, from Quill's channel. Much, much appreciated. So here we go. While you're all here watching, let's see what you can earn. Now, like I said, you can sign up for free at the classic level at www.extra-life.org. Sign up absolutely free to participate. You do get rewarded. We do have low-level rewards like a three-month premium exploit license you'll get. You'll get a discount code for a nice handcrafted wooden smartphone case as Extra Life specific. You know, we get game discount codes, all that good kind of stuff. But if you want to go the extra distance, you want to go the extra mile, what you can do is you can register to become a platinum level participant. You can do that when you register each year for the first time, or you can actually register as a classic level participant, then go back in at any time in the same calendar year and upgrade yourself to platinum. Real easy to do that. You just pay a $19 registration fee and you're platinum level. And that opens up some more rewards for you. That you can earn. So you can earn all the classic level rewards. Plus you can earn some of these platinum level specific rewards. First up is the decal / sticker. So if you raise $75 for your hospital, you get this cool sticker. Next up, for the $200 fundraising milestone as a platinum level participant, you get the Extra Life t-shirt. I'm only $50 away from unlocking this. So I'm hoping with my 100 days of gaming fundraising streams, I can get $50 more raised for my hospital, get my t-shirt unlocked. I can start wearing that on stream. And for the $500, $1,000 levels, you get the silver and gold medals respectively. Now these are platinum only rewards. You have to be registered as a platinum level participant in order to earn these. The good thing is, let's just say you sign up as a platinum or as a classic level at the free level, the classic level. Let's say you sign up as a classic level participant. You do all your fundraising and everything. Let's say you raise $1,000 for your hospital as a classic level. Let's say it's December 31st and you realize, hey, wait a minute, I'm still classic level. I've raised $1,000 for my hospital. You can go in. You can upgrade yourself on December 31st at any time before midnight. Upgrade yourself to platinum level and you automatically unlock this stuff because you have raised those milestones. So you can sign up to be classic level. You can do your fundraising. If you see that you're going to be earning some of this stuff, you might as well upgrade yourself to platinum level and unlock these rewards for you. You want to get the medal out? Okay, we'll show the medal in a minute. And this last one here for raising $100. Now, I saved this one for last because this is not platinum level specific. You as a classic level participant can earn this as well. So this is anyone who's a registered participant, anyone who raises $100 for their hospital will be able to earn the Extra Life G Fuel Starter Kit, which is a shaker plus 7 flavor packs. The caveat is as you can see right here, this is available only to the first 10,000 people. Stop. I don't have the camera up yet. The first 10,000 people who redeem their code, and that code is coming, I would assume, towards the end of this month. So if you've raised $100 for your hospital so far this year, keep an eye out for that email. That way you can redeem this as soon as possible and make sure you get your G Fuel starter kit. So I am anxiously awaiting that email so I can unlock that and get that earned. I can't wait to show that off on stream as well. But yeah, so Abs wanted to show off the medal and there she goes. T-shirt. Yes, I know. I'm $50 away from the t-shirt. Hopefully sometime soon, but there's the medal. This is the first medal I've been able to earn in my 7 years as being an Extra Life participant. So I was able to earn this last year, which is very, very cool. I've been able to get the t-shirt every year. So I've got 6 t-shirts right now. I started in 2013 fundraising for Extra Life. So I was able to get a t-shirt every year so far, which is exciting stuff. So that's why I'm waiting for that last $50 I need to get raised, and I can unlock the t-shirt for myself. And then, of course, start working towards another silver and hopefully gold medal this year. And there's the sticker. So you see the sticker is, now there's my hand. Sticker is pretty decently large. You know, not bad. Show off some Extra Life bling. I got the one from last year too. So the sticker does change every year, just like the logo on the t-shirt. So last year was the first year they did the stickers, the decals. So this was last year, 2018. No, I'm not going to use these stickers because I use them to show off on stream. So I don't want to put them anywhere because then I won't be able to show them off anymore. But yeah, so that's cool stuff. Some just some cool, nice little things that we can do to show our Extra Life support. And at the end of the day, you know, it's at the end of the day, you know, we're raising money for hospitals. We're raising money to save kids' lives. So, you know, that's the ultimate reward there at the end of the day.
Eat the ice cream
one. Oh my God. All right. I'll show you somebody eating ice cream one more time and then that's it. All right.
Happy.
But that's some of the cool Extra Life bling that you can earn and all that kind of stuff. So if anybody's done some fundraising yet, you know, if you're in chat, you've done some fundraising and you want to talk about your fundraising that you've done so far, go ahead. I've done some. What I do throughout the year, I said you got to be quiet when I'm talking. What I do throughout the year, I do a 25-hour gaming marathon on National Game Day weekend.
I see somebody got an ice cream.
Let me see. Oh, they're eating a hot dog. Look at that. Drinking the soda. She's got ice cream. Grandma, she's got ice cream. So we'll let me get out of the fountain so we can see a little bit clearer there.
I want to see the whole thing.
There you go. But, of course, nobody, you guys can't see this. I knew I was going to forget to do that. I knew I was going to forget to do that, too. But there we go. There we go. Now we can see everybody eat ice cream. But, yeah, I do a 25-hour marathon around National Game Day. I actually start mine earlier because I found after the first couple of years I did, like 2013, 2014, I started at 8 a.m. Saturday morning and went to 8 a.m., 9 a.m. Sunday morning. Because, of course, normally National Game Day weekend now is also Daylight Saving Time weekend. So you fall back, so we sort of get that extra hour. But, yeah, the first two weeks I did it, or first 2 weeks, the first 2 years I did my marathon, I started in the morning. So I went 8 a.m. to 8 a.m. And I found that to be kind of rough because you're hitting the overnight hours at the end of your marathon. And then, boy, I was dragging the next day. So I finished up at Sunday. You know, it kills my Sunday because then I got to sleep. So what I found worked best for me for my 25-hour fundraising. Thank you. The Guillaume is now following. Thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Welcome. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the fam. The Extra Life fam. Much appreciated.
I'm seeing everybody do ice cream. I'm happy.
Yeah, they're still unhappy because they want to shop at the souvenir shop right there. I guess I got to put in another souvenir shop. I don't know. That's the only thing I can think of. Uh-oh, female leopard 4 has fallen ill with pad ulcer. Fortunately, we have our veterinarian in there, so our vet should be taking care of the leopard. But yeah, so what I ended up doing, I think starting in 2015, right? 2015, 16, 17, 18. Yeah, I think have I done it? Maybe it's been the last 3 years. Maybe the first 3 years I did 8 to 8. But regardless, what I've done the last couple of years at least was actually start my marathon on Friday. I started earlier. So I would start Friday afternoon and then get the overnight hours sort of in the first half of that 25-hour marathon. So I'd start like 4 or 5 o'clock on Friday p.m., get through the overnight hours, and I'd end like 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon on Saturday. So that gives me time. I guess the overnight hours over earlier, which seemed to help me. And then, where are they looking at? They're staring at everybody out there watching this stream. They're all staring at you people right now. They're eyeing up chat. They're eyeing up chat right now. But yeah, I see that seemed to work better for me because then that gives me a little bit of time to actually catch some of the everybody else's streams on Saturday, because that's what I ended up doing last year. It's like last year, you know, after I ended my stream, I ate dinner, so I was eating dinner. I was watching some other people do their marathons. Then I actually, it kept me on a normal sleep pattern too, because then I was able to go to bed Saturday night, get some normal sleep, wake up Sunday morning and catch the end of the festivities that way as well. So I found that worked out well for me for my marathon.
Oh my God, I'm happy.
Is starting Friday afternoons and then just doing it that way. So it gives me time to maintain a normal sleep pattern and actually, you know, catch some other people's streams that weekend as well. And some of the other stuff I do for fundraising throughout the year, I do mini-thons. I'll pick a day where I can do an 8 to 10-hour stream. And so I'll just do like a little mini-marathon and stream like 5 games. And normally what I'll do is like, I'll break it up throughout the year. I'll try to do like 2 or 3 during the year.
I need to see everybody that goes.
And it'll be thematic. So I'll do one in the spring, which features 5 indie games. So I'll do 5 indie games in the spring. And then, in fact, just this year, I started a mini-thon for classic games. So in June, I did a classic game mini-thon where I played some really old games from like the 90s and the early 2000s. You can do that kind of thing too. So if you don't want to, or you can't do like say a 25-hour marathon, well, you can figure maybe pick a day where you can do 8 or 10 hours and that'll be something fun to do, that kind of stuff. And of course, then, you know, I do on my own channel, I'll do, weekly fundraising streams, or at least at this point with the way I'm trying to work my schedule is do a stream every weekend. Like I'll do Friday, Saturday, and Sunday on my Extra Life channel. I have a channel dedicated strictly to doing Extra Life fundraising streams, which is this channel right here.
Nice.
Streamer. Channel Real Millennium Group. So you can catch me there on Channel Real Millennium Group generally every weekend, Friday through Saturday, is what I normally try to schedule for fundraising streams for Extra Life. So I'll do that every weekend, except for now. Well, I'm doing for 100 Days of Gaming right now. I'm doing 100 Days of Gaming. So I'm actually streaming every single day for at least an hour every day for 100 Days of Gaming. So that will vary based on my work schedule and my stream schedule for my other channels, where I do on Channel BJ Wilder, I just do regular MMOs, indie games, and classic games. And then on RMG Gaming 2, I do simulation games. So I have them scheduled. So I'm working my 100 Days of Gaming around that and my regular work schedule. So, but I am streaming every single day now up until I start my marathon on November 1st on Real Millennium Group there. So, that's stuff you can do too. You can stream every day. But I should also mention, you don't have to be a streamer either to participate or be successful. Out of those 50,000 gamers that we have, not everybody streams. You know, in fact, only a small percentage of that 50,000 gamer participation number actually do streams or videos or anything like that. So you don't have to be a streamer. If you do family game night, you can do Extra Life. If you have a card game with the guys every week or every month or whatever it is, you guys can participate in Extra Life too. So it's really, really easy to participate. There's Wire Junkie. Oh yeah, you forgot I changed times. Yeah, because just the way the school, the school times are going to work out. Just the way the real life schedule changed around a little bit. It's like 7 to 9 is just, I can still do 7 to 9, but it's just too much of a pain in the butt to do it with the schedule changes and with the how school, the kids' school stuff is going to work out now. So 3 to 5 actually works perfectly for me now. So 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern time every Monday afternoon here, right here. You can catch me on the Extra Life for Kids show. Like I said, you can also catch me on Real Millennium Group and BJ Wyler. Real Millennium Group is my Extra Life streaming channel where I do all my Extra Life fundraising, channel dedicated just for that. All variety of games. I will play simulation games, hidden object games, strategy games, games like Wildlife Park, MMOs, multiplayer competitive games, you name it, I will play it for Extra Life. I will
but
play
Daddy,
it for fundraising.
Daddy, add more animals.
Okay, we will add more animals. We will.
Do that
we will.
Right now.
Okay, fine. We'll add more animals.
A lot more.
Enough talking, more animals. The child wants more animals, so we shall add more animals here.
Add 100 more.
Well, I don't think I can add 100 right now, but we'll see what we can add. Here, your kids started change time this year. Yeah, see, what was tough was especially with Erin. With her, she's going into high school now, but with her grade school, it ended up, they get out of school at 3 o'clock. So that essentially killed the 1-3 and the 3-5 time slot on Mondays for me. Because she, you know, she, what she used to do was do what they call homework zone or homework zone, which, you know, gave me extra time. I could do like 1-3 because she wouldn't get out till, you know, four. I wouldn't have to pick her up till like 4:30 or 5. But then she didn't want to do that this year. So that automatically killed the 1-5 p.m. time slots here. So that's, and plus my wife was closing. So it just made it easier where I could, you know, I could do my streams on my channel during the day on Monday, go pick up Aaron, go get dinner, and then get dinner for us, and I can just come in 7-9 to stream and not have to worry about it. But now my wife's working during the days, so I have to start dinner later. I don't have to worry about picking up Aaron at 3 o'clock anymore. So it's like, you know, 3-5 is perfect. You know, I can come here, stream, then I can get up, start dinner, have dinner ready by the time my wife comes home. It's like perfect timing. Son is in second grade and his start time is changing to 7:20 and he will be done at 2:15 now. Wow. Yeah, I think that's Aaron has actually got to go to school early now. She I think school starts for them even, I forgot what it was, because it was 8 o'clock or technically 8:15 at the grade school, but now I think they get her started at like 7:15, 7:30. I forget where her start time is, but it's like obscenely early now. Which is kind of crazy because if you read the studies now and this kind of stuff about teenagers, teenagers actually need more sleep in the morning. They should actually be going. Younger kids should actually be going to school earlier, and teenagers should be going to school later in the morning. Mont Scott, there's Mont Scott. How's it going, Mont Scott? Welcome. But and for some reason we still have high school starting way too early in the morning for the kids anymore.
Daddy, I think we have a baby leopards. Oh, they're both baby leopards.
Well, they would like to mate.
They're both babies.
Yeah, there's no babies yet. Speaking of babies, let's go see if the giraffe is born yet.
Is it boring?
No, she is still pregnant.
Oh my god.
She's still pregnant. No baby giraffe yet. Oh my god. What is the gestation period for giraffes? This has been like 2 years this giraffe has been pregnant. That's why they switched to your times. Oh yeah? Alright.
We're animals right now.
Yeah, but Aaron will actually be done like, I think 2:30, but she'll be riding the bus now. So I don't even have to worry about picking her up, which is nice.
Daddy, can you like add more animals?
Yes, okay. I will think about adding more animals here, but everybody is still so unhappy. Shopping. I got nothing. Well, we're almost at 4 stars. I don't know what to do for shopping. Let me see if there is... Balloon station, antique bench, clothes shop. Okay, so we do have another shop. I gotta wait till I get another star. I gotta wait till we get 4 stars here. Classic railroad station. Ooh, classic rail. We can add in a railroad, and an airship station. Ooh. All right, so they're gonna be unhappy till I can get this 4th star here. But yeah, so hopefully things will work out because this still leaves me the ability to stream during the day on my channels. I do my simulation stream in the morning, and then I do right now EverQuest in the afternoons, and then I wrap up EverQuest and I come right over to here to do this stream. So it works out pretty good right now for me. So hopefully real life stays normalized at this point, and. And we can maintain this schedule for a while because I hate changing times. Clean up some poo, dude.
Now I can't see it.
Yeah, I don't see it anywhere. But they definitely, they're definitely not happy about the cleanliness of the facility here. But I don't see anything.
I want to see poo, though.
I gotta change these gates before we finish up. We still got about 20 minutes, but
look all over that.
I know, I gotta look all over. Oop, stop it. There we go. So I hate when I move my mouse just enough, it exits the window here.
Huh? Wait, go back. I saw something in that box.
Yeah, I don't know what they're talking about. It's, how are you freezing? I got three heaters in this enclosure to cover everywhere. But I don't see any...
Who?
I don't see anything to clean up here. Oh, okay. So I guess he's happy now. He doesn't see any filth. Well, they would both like to mate, but they seem to have trouble getting a little busy there. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Oh, I bought two females. Oh, I thought I bought a male. Oh, my God. Hold on. I could have swore the other one I bought was a male. I just went cheap, and I didn't look to see if it was actually a male. All right, who we got here? He's 290. He's 220. All right, we got to get him. Hold on. No wonder. All right, here you go. Boop. All right. We got our male leopard.
Now add in another animal.
Oh, you know what? I've got to upgrade the aquarium. That's right. This is only 2-star, so I've got to upgrade the aquarium here. So we got freshwater fish. Now we've added coastal fish, so that should help. All right. Boom, we got that done. All right, so that's good. We got that, we got that, we got that. All right. We got our male leopard.
Get out.
We're almost there. We're almost to our 4th star, and hopefully that unlocks a clothes shop. Baby boomer, we've had a baby.
Come on,
is it the giraffe? Is it the giraffe?
Please.
No, it is not the giraffe.
Oh, my God.
But I'm going to have to start selling off some zebras here.
Don't.
The herd is too big. They're not happy. The question is, I've got to decide who I'm selling off here.
But don't sell all of them. Are you going to sell
No, I'm not going to sell all of them. I probably should sell off some of the babies because they might be worth a little more. Now I don't have to worry about mating. So let's go ahead and...
All right,
it's good to sell you. Yep. We'll go ahead and sell you too. Yep.
Now they're happy.
Yeah. God, we got a lot of zebras are like rabbits, man.
Oh, we got.
All right, let me sell this one off too.
Where are the zebras going?
All right, that should help. That should thin the herd a bit. They're going to another park. I'm just selling them to another park. All right, there we go. All right, so we got that upgraded.
We'll see them at another park.
Yeah, we could probably see them at another park. All right, what I need to do now, I want to change the fences here. So let me...
No!
So Emily, I've got to...
Get out!
Sell that. I've got to... Let's... Pause that before somebody decides to go in there and play with the leopards like an idiot. So we'll do that. Because what I want to do now is put the gate over here. That way when we get another enclosure, it'll be easy for these guys to flip over and do... Yeah, see, it's not going to... I didn't think it was going to go on the hill. So it's got to go down here. That's about as far as it'll go. So we'll go right there with it. All right, so that's that. Tuberculosis, oh my God. And then what I need to do is the same thing over here with the giraffes. So let's get down in here. So this is actually a different fence entirely here. That's good. Sell that. This is... It's not bamboo. I think this is the palisade. I think this is the palisade fence here. And I think we have it this color.
the brown one.
Yep, it's the brown one. So there we go with that.
I've been waiting for that one for 10 hours.
Oh, no, you weren't. All right, so what we'll do, we'll go over here. And we'll throw the gate in here. We'll put it, maybe it's not. Maybe it's the light one. Oh, it's the light one. So I guess I just... Maybe I did this as a dark.
I want to see.
Yeah, I think that. Yeah, all right. I did the wrong color. That's fine. We already looked in the bird enclosure earlier, so we'll put this one right here.
I want to look in it one more time.
All right, hold on, Abs. Let me finish doing what I need to do here. All right, so we'll sell that, and I'll go. I could have swore I used the dark one, but I guess I didn't. Nope. This. All right, there we go. That takes care of that. All right, so that takes care of that. So let's go back in here. So we're good there. Back, close that. We almost got our start. Ah, yes, there we go. Did we get it? Yes. Increase the new billing options have been unlocked. More visitors with higher demands come to the park, so please ensure. Okay, so good. We got 4 stars. She wants to go see in the bird enclosure, so let's get over. Let's pause because we got a lot of work to do right now. So we're going to go down here into the bird enclosure. And we have received a new secondary mission, so we'll have to check that out.
Oh!
There we go. There's the bird enclosure.
Is there birds?
No, unfortunately, you can't see the birds here.
Where are the birds?
Well, they didn't make the birds for here, so it's just have to pretend we can see the birds.
The birds are up there.
Yes, that's where the birds are. There we go. There's the birds.
Cute.
Okay, so we've got to upgrade. We got to upgrade all our buildings. Let's start in the back here. So let's go ahead and upgrade this. So now we got sea fish. Let's upgrade this. So now we have birds of prey. That'll be interesting.
The birds are in there.
Yes, the birds are in there.
We're not pretending there's birds in there anymore.
Yeah, well, no, we still have to pretend the birds are in there. So now we have an ape head balloon, heart shape. So we're just going to unlock everything we can unlock here. We're good there.
One blocking animals.
Yep, so we can upgrade our toilets. I think we can upgrade our toilets. Self-cleaning toilets. Yeah, baby. There we go. All right, so let's go ahead and upgrade this.
The ice cream shop.
Yep, so, we can't upgrade that anymore. That's it. Okay, so what we got, I think this is completely upgraded too. Oh, no, okay. Ice cream bomb. All right. We'll have to see what that's all about. So, all right, those are the buildings there.
Add more.
I didn't think that was upgraded. So let's see.
Next step,
we got to go down here.
Adding more animals.
That's already upgraded as far as it will go. Let's upgrade this bathroom to be a self-cleaning bathroom. So we're good there. I think we can raise ticket prices here. So let's check that out. Let's see here.
Can you add more animals?
Customize. Oh, we could customize that too. Mm-hmm. I'll leave it for now.
Add more animals. I want to see that.
Hold on here.
Add more animals.
Oh, here we go. So I think we can probably bump this up to $4. We'll double the price now. $4 entrance fee.
Add more new animals.
So everything is upgraded. So we got that. So what I want to do now is add a shop here. Clothes shop.
Let me see somebody eat.
Relax, Abs. Thank you, Guthrie, for the shout outs as well and the schedule. Much appreciated.
For ice cream. I'm dying.
See what decorative items we got here, too. What's this?
No,
I... Oh, a dinosaur statue. Okay.
I want to get...
Skull fountain. T-Rex skeleton.
I want to get more new animals.
So looks like we only got one more. We got a T-Rex statue we can unlock. Okay. It's not much in the way of decorative stuff. But clothes shop, right? So we got a restaurant unlocked. Perfect.
Now I want to get...
So we're gonna have to think about Jeep tours too, yeah. Aren't we?
Get more new animals.
Balloons.
Right?
Ooh, what's this? What is this? I guess it makes balloons or something? I have no idea what that is. We'll have to find out.
Go to Bobcorn.
I got some antique benches. Monorail. I wanted to do a monorail. I think I'll do a monorail before I'll do the Jeep stuff. But we got a restaurant and a clothes shop. How big is the clothes shop? Okay.
No, I said more new animals.
Stop. Now, this is the question. Where do I want to put the clothes shop? I'd love to have it here, but it's just, I'm not going to be able to do it here. It's just not going to make sense to put it here.
Don't put it somewhere like this open and clear.
All these people want to go shopping. See, now maybe I'm thinking I should have left a little bit more space in here. I could put the clothes shop in between. So I think I'm going to have to put the clothes shop out here somewhere.
They're going to look for the clothes shop.
Yeah. Wow, this is a quandary. This is a quandary.
I want to look inside.
Because this is going to be such an odd place to put it here. You're lurking and working on stuff. Cool. That's kind of what I do. I'll lurk in the channel and try to get all sorts of video work and everything else done. What?
I want to look inside the clothes shop.
We can't look inside the clothes shop. It's just like the souvenir shop. We're not going to be able to see anything.
Well, let me just look in. Wait, let me look in.
Right, maybe I can do this. Oh, writing a story for a video game contract. Nice. Nice. See, that's what I probably should have done, because I like writing, but...
Ice cream.
So I think, yeah, let's... Alright, let's do it this way. Put the clothes shop there, now, then I can just have the path come up this way.
Now let me look inside.
Alright, fine, we'll look inside. There we go.
Can we actually go in the doors?
Yeah, we can go in the doors, but see, you're not going to be able to see anything.
Why?
Because it's not made to look in, Abs. This is just one building we're not made to go in for, okay?
You can go in the others.
Yeah, some of the others we can go. Some buildings we can go in, other buildings we can't.
What building can we go in?
We can go into the aquarium and we can go into the aviary.
I want to go to the aviary.
That's the birdhouse. The aviary is the birdhouse.
Oh, where other things can we go in?
That's it. That's all we can go in for now. So we'll just do it this way. There we go. All right, so we'll do that. We'll bring the pathway up this way.
I can look at the clothes people bring out.
Yeah, we'll see if they bring any clothes out here. So we'll bring the path up that way.
Animals.
We'll do this. We'll do it like this, I think. We'll do it like that. There we go.
Add in more animals.
There we go. I don't think I need anything on that side. There we go.
Add in more animals.
Stop. I'm
clothes.
I will when I'm ready.
I see clothes.
I think we're good there. Okay, so
I
we got
see
that.
Nice clothes, Daddy. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Nice clothes.
Let's, is there another bench down here? I think I was doing
animals.
Stop, I will. You gotta give me a break, Abs, alright?
Grab more animals in a minute.
Yeah. Well, actually no, because we're not gonna have time. We're gonna have to wait till next week to add an animal. But nice, good luck with that story. That'll be very nice.
One more
You'll have to let us know game it's for, so we can check it out. I will definitely check
Daddy,
that out.
Add a woman, and we'll add in the elephants.
Want to add the elephants next? Okay, we can add the elephants next.
Okay. Add two more animals in. Add a tiger and the elephant.
Okay. Do we have? I don't know if we have tigers yet. I don't remember seeing tigers.
See, we have tigers on these.
Leopard, puma, elephant, bear, hippo, jaguar, or panther. Panther. Yeah, panther. Lion. White lion. Oh, yeah. Chimpanzees, penguins, rhinos. Ooh, snow leopard. Oh, yeah, we got tigers. We have our shelves some tigers. All right. We're definitely going to have to add a lot of animals next week. We really didn't do too much with our animals this week. We added the leopards, and that was it. It's more or less doing a little bit of maintenance here. Speaking of which, let me do this real quick before we wrap today up.
But first, I want to...
Choose your own adventure story. Oh, nice. I like this.
I want to add in three more animals.
I think I still have a whole bunch of the old, or my parents have a whole bunch of my old Choose Your Own Adventure books back from when I was a kid. I used to love those things. I ended up using the cheat too with them.
Adding three more animals. Three more.
Now, next week I'll add animals. Because what I ended up used to do is... Stop, I'm talking. You got... Okay, stop. I'm talking now. I told you, you got to be quiet when I'm talking. What I used to do, because I used to love reading the things, what I used to do is when I came to a choice I wasn't sure about, I was like, I don't know what to choose.
Daddy, you're going to add in two more animals?
Yes, I'm going to add in two more animals if you be quiet. Mm-hmm. What I ended up doing is like I would read ahead. I would actually skip to the end. I would find the pages where it take you through the book. Say, okay, what's this choice do? Okay, what's this choice do? I'm gonna choose this one. I like this one better. So I used to cheat reading those books so I could pick the choice that I pick the outcome that I wanted to have. Which kind of defeated the purpose, of reading those books. Was sort of the novelty, the adventure of not knowing what your choice would lead to. Alright, so I got to... No, I didn't want to do that. I want to bulldoze, thank you. Yeah, I bulldozed my gate. I'm not surprised about that. Or my fence part there. Juji Fruit is hosting. Thank you for the host, Juji Fruit. Much appreciated. Yeah, I knew that was going to happen. So I'm going to have to rebuild that. So I don't want to break my gate, so we'll do that. Hey, Juji Fruit, how's it going? Welcome. Thank you for the host. So we're going to have to rebuild our gate.
And two more animals.
This is the yellow gate, I think. Or yellow fence, I should say. There we go.
You're gonna add more animals.
All right, so we got that.
Add in two more.
Can't stream, but begin host. That's what I'm gonna do. Ah, nice, nice. Hosts are always welcome. All right, so now all I can do is do some savanna grass here.
Happy daddy to you.
Alright, let's see. Ground. Here we go. Savannah grass.
Daddy, dog daddy.
Alright, so good. Now we can just get this grassy here. There we go. That'll work. Nice.
Happy daddy, what do you do?
Yeah, okay. So we got that fixed up nice and neat.
Now add in two more animals.
All right, fine. We'll add in an animal because, we're going to have to update the schedules.
Okay, daddy.
I don't think Andre's streaming anymore. Daddy. Happy daddy to you. Oh, my God. I know.
Daddy, daddy added
Cutie sometimes.
My daddy added two more animals.
I'm going to add in one more animal because I got to start dinner. I got to get dinner going.
You add in another animal next time.
Yeah, we can add in another animal next time. I just got to figure out where I... I guess it makes sense if I just add the animal over here because I've already got my vet and my zookeeper covered there. So let's put them over here. So what animal do you want me to add?
I want you to add in a new animal we didn't have. I want you to add in...
Because we got, you said the tiger, we got the lions.
I want to have...
We got the, what do we got the snow leopard, but that's not a savannah animal. I'm going to want a savannah animal.
I want the tiger.
You want the tigers?
Yeah, with the baby tiger too.
Well, we don't have a baby tiger available yet. So, we can put a couple in there and they'll make a baby tiger. Oh, this is what I want to do.
I'm happy.
Savannah grass, or, oh, they like soil, really. I expected that to be savannah grass. Alright, soil it is. They like to jump, climb, swim. Ooh, so we're going, okay, so this is going to be interesting. So we're going to have to figure that out. Let's get over here because I'm going to want to... I don't necessarily need to bulldoze that, I don't think.
Yep, do it. And I want to pick the gate too.
I'm trying to think how I want to set up the enclosure. So I'm thinking if use this as a shared wall, because I did a lot of that in Zoo Tycoon too. I used to have shared walls between a lot of the exhibits. Like this one here, we could have a shared wall, but I've got, you know, I left it open for these animals. But obviously we, and you know, we're not quite, don't want to mix a tiger and a giraffe. So I'm thinking whether I want to do shared wall, but then I will need a... Well, do I really need a gate? Because technically, these guys don't leave the enclosures. Really, from the game mechanics, they don't leave the enclosures. Well, let's do this. I would have to do a new save, wouldn't I? I'm trying to think if I want to... Because if I don't... Well, even if I don't do a shared, I'm going to need to run the path this way anyway.
There's a whole bunch of paths.
Nah, I won't do a shared. Or maybe a... Yeah... I can't make up my mind whether I want to do a shared wall or not.
Do a daddy. I want...
Well, you know what? Let's experiment. Let's do a shared wall.
I want the...
We'll do a shared wall, just to see.
Yeah, I want a shared wall.
Okay. Just to see. Oh, what I need to do first is bulldoze the stuff I don't need here. Or don't want in the exhibit. Which is you. You, I'm gonna have to bulldoze you. Which means I'm gonna have to, in fact, yeah, I will have to bulldoze both of these now. Alright, there we go. So let's go ahead and get our fence set up here. So we'll experiment and see if a shared wall makes a difference with anything. Because it could, in the long run, save us a little bit of space. I got to see. I want to make it about... I think that's about a good size for tigers. I got to remember, I got to get some water in here. It's right about there. Oh, dadnabbit. I just wanted to make sure it was straight. See the one? See, this is where I should have the grid lines. Just so I know I'm making the walls straight. We'll do it like this, okay. So that's about straight. And we'll go here like that there. So technically I shouldn't need a gate outside, or at least I would only need one gate in either one of these for leading outside. So we did this way. So we experimented a little bit with that. So we'll experiment with just a shared wall and see what happens. All right, so now we need soil. I gotta get soil in here. So let's do this.
Soil.
I just see here, I just gotta watch that it doesn't bleed over into the other exhibit. So let's open this up a bit here.
Put it all over.
So they prefer soil. I'll bring it out like that because I could always dial it. Get this back to grass here. There we go. Just got to watch here. It doesn't, yeah. All right, it won't be bleeding over too much, which is perfect. So soil. That is soil, right? Soil, yes. Soil brown. Soil brown. Yeah, oh yeah, much easier. Yeah, you can sort of paint the surface, which, yeah, definitely is much easier than doing it square by square here. We're going to just bring this back here a bit. So that bleeds over a little bit too much there. So, yeah, this isn't exactly straight here. So that's a problem. It's going to bleed over one way or the other. So we'll just do it like that. There we go. I'll sort of blend it in that way. All right, let's see what else these tigers need here.
And added one more.
The tiger's it, because I'm getting hungry. I barely had any lunch. I had a lot to do today, and I barely ate anything today.
Just one more, that's all I want.
We're adding the tigers, and that's going to be it. So they're going to need temperature, so they're going to need a heat lamp. So we're getting water. They want to swim, so we're going to have to make a pool in here. So I got to figure out how to do a pool. So that's going to be key. Yeah, I love tigers.
I like tigers.
I love all the big cats. I love cats,
Daddy,
in general. But
Daddy,
the big...
I like the tigers too. My other favorite animal I like is the meerkats.
You like the meerkats? Cool.
Yeah.
3 months gestation period. You know what? Hold on a second here.
And I like the giraffe too. And the lions and the elephants. I like every animal at the zoo. Oh, it's cute.
15 months gestation period for a giraffe. Okay.
Oh my god.
It's gotta be longer than 15 months that this giraffe has been. I haven't really been watching. I haven't really paid attention to the time here. But I guess it might be right. If we're going, if we're not going fast, we might not have gotten a year yet since we brought our giraffes in.
Can I eat some salt?
All right, so let's get save this. So now we've got to figure out water. Okay, this is what we want. We want water. So I gotta see. Oof. Okay, so we got some water here. So they'll have a place to swim. All right, so there we go. Now what I'm going to have to do, I'm going to have to level this out a bit here. I think I'm going to have to lower this terrain first here. So let's lower this over this over here. And I think what we're going to have to do is sort of smooth it out here. I'm not even sure if this is doing anything. I'll make terrain round. Is there a leveling? Gradually, that might... Ooh, that's more than gradual.
They can swim.
Oh, is this the flattened terrain? Here we go. There you go. So let's flatten this up a bit here.
They're going to love to swim.
Yes, they are.
Can you put them in the water and not on their food?
I suppose I could. So we're going to want to very gently just raise this up a bit here. That way that makes it there you go, makes it more a little bit more sloped here, I think.
I wanna touch the go into the water.
I think that works.
Go into the water.
So let's do there we go. We'll do it that way. There we go.
Now I wanna go into the water.
Stop. We can't go in the water. Oh, yeah, we can. Oh, okay. I guess we can go in the water.
We can go underwater.
Look at that. We are underwater. All right.
Can they tie?
What's my missions, by the way? Tasks? I have no tasks. I actually should have completed this mission, but we're going to stick with it here. All right, good. So we got that. Just looks... We're going to need some plants. All right, let's get some flora and fauna in here. What likes soil? So I wish I could filter by what...
Tigers like soil.
Is there a way to filter? Sort by attracting... See, this is where I wish I could say, just show me plants that like soil.
I'm done with you.
So let's see. Grass. I think all this... That's mud. Grass.
Do mud
grass,
again.
Grass.
I want to see mud.
Grass, grass. Mud, grass, mud, grass. Mud. We could actually do mud.
Yeah, do mud, do mud.
So I could throw a couple of these in here.
In the water?
Like right here? Let's do mud here.
Mud.
That's mud there. Let's come down here. We'll make this muddy here. Make this little area muddy.
Can we step in the mud, Ash? Let me see if we can do that.
Okay, so we'll do, now we're not going to step in the mud.
Let me see.
No, we're not going to step in the mud. So now I can...
Let's just do it anyways.
We can do it like this. Here we go.
Let's go in the mud.
Put a bunch of these things out here.
Let's go in the mud.
I guess I should eventually hire a gardener, too, because to take care of all the plants we got here. There we go. So that's cool. That's cool. We got that there.
Oh, wait, right. Get a tiger and put it in the water.
Stop. I gotta get the exhibit ready first. Alright, so we're gonna have to find something that likes mud. So let's get her in for soil. Grass. I'm sure I can throw some grass. Okay, soil. Here we go. What is this?
It's a plant.
Monstera. Monsteras? Okay. So we got that. So let's good, put you there. We'll throw some of you around here. Like this. Like that. A couple over here. There we go. So okay, so let's see what else we have here.
I'm done.
Oh,
I can't lift my foot up as long.
All sorts of different shapes and colors and sizes. Ooh.
It's a lala. Lalo.
Oh, that one looks... So let me throw this one in here. I'll throw this one down in here, a couple of these down there. All right, it's good enough. Let's see what else we need soil here. I know, so that's savanna grass. That's the orange tree. That's savanna soil. Okay.
Soil.
What is this? The banana. Oh, the banana tree. All right, banana tree. Yeah, we can do banana tree. All right, we'll throw a banana tree here. We'll put one there. That's we'll put a couple out over here if we can. Here we go. We'll get them right like that. We'll throw one out in the corner here.
Go
I gotta watch because we don't want too much because they might not like a lot of flora and fauna, but I gotta do something to, you know, green this up a bit here. So let's see what else we got here.
Daddy, can you like put, I wanna step in the mud, so go in the mud.
Soil.
Go in the mud. Go in the mud.
Palm fruit, okay.
Go in the mud. Go in the mud.
Oh, that looks interesting.
Go in the mud, go
this
in
is
the
soil.
Mud,
go. All right, we'll do a couple of these and that'll be it. We'll put this one out here. Can we put this one out here? Yeah, we'll put it out there. There we go. All right, I think that'll work.
Wait, now let's step in the mud.
All right, no, we're not going to step in the mud. I told you, Ab.
Yeah,
seriously.
Let's just step in
Stop.
The mud.
Stop.
Mud. Everybody's gonna be very happy.
All right, so what do we need? They need scratch. I think it was scratching. I think they needed to scratch here. Gotta get all the way down here.
Tiger.
They like to jump. They like to climb. All right, we got swimming out of the way, hopefully. They like to scratch,
swim,
climb, and jump. So we shall need
the jump.
A climbing tree,
yeah,
which we'll put right here. They like to scratch, which the branches generally are for. So we'll just throw some branches down here. How's that? We'll throw the branches right there. And jump.
Yeah.
So they are. Hanging frame.
Hanging?
Oh, it's got to be for the monkeys. And so we will do...
Monkey.
Low, high, high, low.
I want high.
High hurdle? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you might be able to do a high hurdle. So we'll throw that over here. So they'll get their toys there. Oh, you know what we're going to need? We're going to need food and water. Meat, obviously.
Yeah, obviously stinky meat.
So we'll throw some meat out here.
And throw fruit for them.
They don't eat fruit, but they will need some water.
To drink
out. So we'll throw the water over here for them.
Why can't they drink in the river?
Den. Do tigers live in dens? We'll see. I'll hold off on giving them a house. So, I mean, I gave them a den, but I don't even know if they use it. I'll have to watch them. I'll have to observe them for a bit and see if they actually use the den. We will need heat. Oh. Look at that. That's quite convenient. Problem is the fence is right there, so we'll have to not in real life, I don't think. Okay, yeah, see, it depends. Sometimes in game, you know, like in Zoo Tycoon, all the animals, you always wanted to have some sort of shelter for the animals, but I don't think that's necessarily the case in this one. But I'll go without den, because right now I got it pretty crowded. I might have to get rid of that tree and throw the den there if they feel like they need the den. But I don't think they do. Yeah, Zoo Tycoon is awesome.
You're playing
Both of them really were awesome. I loved playing them. The problem is with the original one, there were a few animals, I think it was the panther or the black jaguar. There were some animals just extremely, extremely hard to keep happy, because you had to have their enclosure precise. The precise amount of soil that they preferred, the precise amount of rocks, the precise amount of vegetation. Everything had to be exact. Otherwise, they were not happy. And there was a great site for Zoo Tycoon that basically listed every single animal and listed exactly the size of the enclosure and what you needed for that size enclosure to keep them happy. And when I started playing Zoo Tycoon, I guess like 3 or 4 years ago, I stumbled across the site, said, oh, perfect. So I started setting up my zoo according to the guides for the animals. It was very difficult. And then 3 or 4 months later, the site shut down. I'm like, no, you got to be kidding me.
Come on.
I don't care if they're not used to the climate. Those animals have to suffer through bad weather like they have to do in the wild. Nice.
Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, but that was really only the original. I think Zoo Tycoon 2 sort of eliminated the preciseness you needed. Because it's been a while. It's probably been at least a year since I played Zoo Tycoon 2. And I don't remember if there was even any, you even had to worry too much about happiness in that kind of micromanagement aspect. But yeah, it was when I found out the site had shut down, I was like, you've got to be kidding me. No, it's the only site that had the exact details you needed for every single animal. So now I have to make sure I have my save games preserver Zoo Tycoon, because I'll have to go back and look at the enclosures if I want to do something new with them. But I think we're good. I mean, we've got their toys. We got most of the climate control. I mean, I'm going to end up with another exhibit here, which will need climate control. So for 3 exhibits, I'll only need the 2. So that should be able to help us.
You got one more animal. Right.
Now, no more animals today because it's already late. I've already gone overtime here again, like last week. But,
Added the leopards and you're adding in now the tigers.
Yeah, I'm going to add in the tigers. I don't think I need anything else right now. I think we're good. That's the shelter. We got their food and water. We got the fence up. We got their toys.
Toys!
So that's it. Let's get some tigers in here. And we got these guys should...
Remember to put a tiger in the water.
Yep. So we will want to move him... Actually, I don't even need to move him, because what I could do, I could just expand his zone.
Oh wait, add in
there we
tiger.
Go. And that covers it. That covers everything there.
But put in tiger.
I can
in the
expand
water.
The vet's zone.
For the augers.
All right, there, and that covers that. All right. See, that's one thing I like about Zoo Tycoon over Wildlife Park here is that for your zookeepers and your staff, you don't assign them a general area. You assign them specific exhibits. So I could take this guy and say, okay, you take care of this exhibit, this exhibit, this exhibit. That's your responsibility. You know, I could assign, you know, another zookeeper, you take care of this, you take care of this, you take care of that one. This one, you give them an area, and then you hope you have that their area of coverage will be able to cover more than one exhibit. I know, tiger time. It's tiger time. I am Eastern time as well. I live in Pennsylvania. So I support the Children's Hospital of Pennsylvania for my extra life efforts. Stop. All right, here we go. Tiger time. Let's unleash the tigers. So let's see what we got here. We got a, he's 320. All right.
Remember to put a lion in the water.
And he's old too. He's 4 years old. But he's a 4-star tiger.
But remember to
right,
put
she's
a tiger.
5 years, but a 3-star
Wait,
tiger.
Daddy.
What?
Remember the tiger?
Okay, I will put them in the water. She's five, so she's nice and young. She's $290, 3 stars. He's, ooh, 190. What's this? This is a male 3 star, 4 years old, perfect. I just found my two tigers. So curious. This guy's a little old. These two, all right. It's going to be these two, so fine. We will,
put it in the water.
We will put the tigers in. Let's make sure that was male, right? Male. All right, there's my female. I want the female. make sure I buy the right animals here.
There's our female.
They're there.
We need to buy
that. We are good to go, and we are good to splash down.
Yay, let's see if they can go in the water.
Very thirsty, worn out. They're swimming. Look at them swim. Aww. That is awesome.
Oh, he got it. He can run.
There's our tigers. Oh, he's climbing. Or she. Is that the... That's the he. So the male one is paler. She's... The female is orange. So the male is more yellow. The female is orange. Look at that. Look at him go. I would love to have a tiger as a pet.
To go in the pool.
I would love to get. I know there's some breed. There's a breed of cat in the. I think it's called. I think it's
go
the
Savannah. Go in the water. Go in the water.
I will. Next time they go in the water, I'll go. I'll go in the water.
And, no, go in the water one more time.
Okay, here we go. We're underwater. Let's see if the tiger comes in. We see him swimming. We'll park here. But there's a breed of cat called the Savannah, which is a cat very close. Oh, there he is. Very close to the wildcats. Look at that. That is awesome.
Look at him climbing. He's scratching.
And so I would love to be able to get a Savannah.
Let's see if the other one comes.
Because they're sort of like the Savannahs are, I guess, are the wolf dog of the domesticated cat population. Because my aunt used to own a wolf dog, and it was 90% wolf.
It's climbing.
And it was a great dog. But yeah, Savannah is sort of the wolf dog of the cat population. I'd love to get a Savannah.
Well, I would love to get a tiger as my pet.
Well, I would love to have a tiger too, but they're a little bit tougher to take care of, and they're still wild animals. I mean, even if we get a newborn tiger and domesticate it, it's still gonna
be wild.
And they get to be big. Yeah, they are big cats. It would eat you, Abs. It would try to eat you one day.
And I would run away from it.
Believe me, you're not gonna run away from a tiger. It will catch you.
They run so fast.
There used to be a tiger preserve in Jackson, New Jersey, near where the Great Adventure theme park is. And unfortunately, they had some issues many, many years ago. And the state ended up coming in and taking all the tigers away under the guise that the tigers were not well kept, and that the conditions were deplorable and this and that, but really, which I think was true to some extent, but I don't think it was as bad as the state was making it out to be. And what ended up happening was they took all the tigers. A lot of them died, unfortunately, because tigers do not transport well. But really, the real reason that
Daddy,
the state
can we go up? Can
went
we go up?
Shh, the state went in there and wanted to, it was a land grab for the state. They wanted to develop the land, and they couldn't. They wanted the land for many, many years.
Where's the tiger?
And so, that's not warm enough for them.
People got inside. Oh.
Yeah, they're not happy. Oh, why are they not happy? Oh, the water's not deep enough. Really? All right, so do I have to... I guess I have to make some water here, then. I guess we have to go make some water here. Is that better? But then that looks like that's a little too deep there. Let's Oh, no. Let's bring this up.
Now I want to go into all the bad Steve.
Hold on. Oh, what's this? Tricky Mick just subscribed. Thank you, Tricky Mick. What is this? 23 months? Almost 2 years. Almost 2 years. Awesome. Thank you for the resub, Tricky. Thank you for the resub. Much appreciated. All right, so we got that. All right, looks like it's happy now. Let's see if I can raise this up just a touch here.
Wait, now let's go in the water.
Just a touch here.
Let's go in the water so I stop getting rained on.
So there we go.
Let's go in the water, in the water, in the water.
No, we're not going to go in the water now. It's thunderstorming. But here's the problem. Yeah, if they go out here, they're too cold. It's too cold for these plants here because the heat doesn't radiate that far out. Yeah, see, now he's going to be warm.
Wait, let me go in the water, water. Go in the water.
See, I don't know if I just want to sell those or just wait until you know what, we'll wait, because we're going to put another enclosure over here anyway.
You have successfully completed your secondary mission, and a reward is now waiting for you in the achievements menu.
What mission was that? I even know what my mission was.
Daddy,
so what's this? Oh, 5,000. We will take $5,000 indeed. There we go. All right, good. All right, that's going to have to be it for me.
We've gone over time once again.
I got to start dinner. I am starving. I have got to start dinner. But we'll be back again next week with more Wildlife Park 3. Same bat time, same bat channel, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern time. Thank you for joining me today, everyone. Thank you for the hosts. Thank you for the subscriptions. It is much, much appreciated. Once again, I am BJ Weiler. You can catch me both on channel BJ Weiler. Let me see if I can type correctly. I can't type. You can catch me both on channel B. Oh, yes, that's right. I can't give myself a shout out, but I can shout out my other channel here. This channel here. You can click BJ Weiler in chat there and get to my channel. And you can also catch me on channel Real Millennium Group. Real Millennium Group is where I do all my Extra Life specific streams and fundraising efforts. So I fundraise for the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. So you'll catch all my fundraising streams on channel Real Millennium Group. Right now, I am streaming every single day for at least 1 hour every day on channel Real Millennium Group for 100 Days of Gaming. I just wrapped up my day 13 stream this morning.
Daddy.
Tomorrow we'll be doing day 14. Wait.
I know.
Wait until I'm done talking. So I will be doing day 14 for 100 Days of Gaming tomorrow. We are streaming for 100 consecutive days. I will begin my 25-hour gaming marathon on Friday, November 1st.
Oh,
oh! Nobody saw that, right? Nobody saw that. Oops. I better go to the other camera view here. Whoa, we're getting into some... non-kid-friendly territory there. Okay. Them tigers. Oh, boy. Them tigers. Anyway, thank you for joining me today, everyone. Much, much appreciated. Again, you can catch me on channel BJ Weiler. Catch me on channel Real Millennium Group. And we'll be back again with some more Wildlife Park 3. We're going to continue with Wildlife Park 3 for the rest of August every Monday. And then I think starting in September, I'm going to do a little Cook, Serve, Delicious 2. So stay tuned for that right here on the Extra Life for Kids show every Monday from 3 to 5 p.m. I am out. I'm going to have to wrap up. Wire Junkie will be back in a couple of hours, 4 hours, I think. Wire Junkie will be back right here, 9 p.m. Eastern. So everybody be sure to come back and catch Wire Junkie as well. I am BJ Weiler. Thank you for watching, everyone. This is Abby the Troll. Wave to everybody since you are our guest star today. Here, put your face in the camera. There you go. There's Abby the Troll. She's a regular guest star on my own channels as well. So thank you for watching, everyone. Until next time,
see you in game for helping sick kids get better.
We will see you in game. Yes, we are helping sick kids get better. Thank you, everyone.
Appreciated.
Much appreciated being your host for today. Everybody have a wonderful week. Have a safe week. And we will catch you next time.
Play this game tomorrow.
Okay.
So I can get more animals in.
Okay.
Any animal I want. Elephants, panda bear, sure. Use anything. Yes,
any animal you want. Absolutely.
You'll do any animal I want.
Yes, absolutely. If it keeps you quiet, I will do any animal you want.